The locality where I live in is surrounded by lots of coconut trees. Almost every house has got its own coconut tree. The coconut tree in our backyard is here since my childhood. My father planted it himself. Now it has become a kind of member of our family. After planting this coconut tree, though we didn't take much care of it, the tree gives us quite a lot of things. Like keeping our house cool in the hot and humid summer days, providing shade, and of course, the coconuts. These people come every now and then to clean up the tree and to bring down the coconuts. For me, this entire cleaning process is quite interesting. The main vein of the leaves will be used later to make good bloom after completely drying them in sunlight. The couple took ₹100 for this walk and we gave them 2 coconuts. Their main intention was to buy these coconuts at a low price from us and sell those to open market. But obviously, we are not interested in selling those coconuts. My mother is going to make Nadu out of it. The maid working at our home is helping my mother to do this. This coconut water tastes great and it is healthy too. We consider it as a healthy replacement of soft drinks available in markets. Naru is a traditional Bengali sweet which we generally have during any auspicious occasion. But it is not necessary to have them only during occasion. You can have it anytime. Just like now, we are making this. During Lakshmi Puja and Durga Puja, we offer this to the guests. I am not making this video to demonstrate the recipe of this sweet, but to explore the unnoticed relationship that we have with this coconut tree. So the Narus are ready. The leftover coconut shells, which are now drying in our backyard, will also be used later. After drying them, we generally burn them and the smoke is used as an insect repellent. And I forgot to mention that this outer shell of this coconut is also used for various cleaning purposes. Now I am on the roof, eating these tasty narus made by my mother. Just in front of me is the coconut tree. And I feel a kind of imperceptible attachment with the tree. Since my father planted it, this coconut tree continues to show its gratitude to us, which is now rare to be found in most of the living human beings. So the tree stays with us as a mute witness of our life, continues to help us, and our life goes on.